Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Sūpā Mario Galaxy... Wait... Two! There he is! Alright, so last time we finished up World 1. We got all the rest of the stars there, a couple secret stars I believe, or one secret star, and made our way to World 2 after defeating Bowser Jr. What is my Wii Remote doing? Wii Remote? Hold on. Okay, I think my mic stand might have been in the way of my Wii Remote. Or it's doing that thing. Well, I guess we're having an episode of my Wii Remote acting up. Okay, this time we're gonna be starting up World 2, starting here with Puzzle Plank Galaxy. Now, like I said at the end of the last episode, this is easily one of my favorite galaxies, mainly for its music. So we are gonna be doing the Puzzling Picture Block. How can you not love that music? Anyway, so starting off here on the puzzling picture block. Well, I guess they're all puzzling picture blocks. You got these little things that you can ground pound into. That is basically how we're gonna be moving through this area. I mean, you don't have to hit these end ones. You're basically just supposed to do this. It takes you down here. Get him, P2! No thank you. Because you don't actually have a P2, it's just two. Anyway, let's get the music. Okay, I screwed that up. Okay then. I guess I'm supposed to have killed the Wigglers first, because that was bad, but you recognize the music. Alright, that's the one that we're actually supposed to hit. Also, yeah, my Wii Remote's doing that weird thing where it's, like, I'm just gonna kinda jump around a little bit, and not be quite as smooth as usual. That happened in Galaxy 1 as well. It only ever happens in the Galaxy games for some reason. And I realized that before starting this episode, I've been alternating between playing this game on the Wii U Virtual Console version and the disc version that I have. Also, there's a Hungry Luma right there that we are not going to be talking to right away. We're actually going to go in here. We got a little secret in here. Let's see what this is. This is the coins, so this is how we're going to be feeding that Hungry Luma when we come back. So, we're not going to be doing that right now. We left the Luma right there. So what you're supposed to do is get up here, and actually, what does hitting that do? Nope! Is that more coins? Come on, get up there, bro. Kill that guy. That is more coins. Alright, we're supposed to ground pound those through, kind of like in Dusty Dune Galaxy, but you can also just backflip and do that. Alright, so we're only actually on the puzzling picture block for a little bit of time at the beginning, and now we're just on these saw blade platforms. There's the comet metal right there. And basically, you just gotta navigate through without being killed, and without falling, because, I mean, the saw blades are cutting all of the platforms that we're gonna be standing on, so you just gotta essentially get a long jump your way through this area and be pretty much fine. I'll admit, I like to think I'm pretty dang good. Oh, wow, that guy died. I like to think I'm pretty dang good at the Galaxy games. Spoilers, I did win both verses on the Galaxy games. However, I guess that these levels are designed, all the games are kind of designed with like a younger audience in mind, but still, you know. Oh, I don't even have enough star bits for this guy. You understand me, you get me. I like to think I'm good and know the shortcuts and stuff. Anyway, let's fly through this launch star and see what we have coming up. Oh. For some reason, I was thinking this was a boss fight. And actually, this is the puzzling picture block. What am I... Okay. Maybe the boss fight comes once we do this. Oh, I can't do that side yet. Crap. Oh, and of course now we're gonna get enough star bits so that, to where we could have bought a freaking life stream or whatever. Alright. So, with the gravity, you can stop screwing up. There you go. You just got... Mario! Ground pound this. Thank you. Okay, that's kind of a little bit of an oversight right there. Oh, I'm not an oversight. Just a little bit of glitchy controls. All right, and doing this should give us something. Oh, the Co-Star Luma disappeared. Alright, we have this guy. This is not Bugaboom. I was about to call him Bugaboom. I believe this is just one of the Mandibugs. Just like a big old Mandibug. Wait, are these the Mandibugs? I completely forget their names. Yeah, this is just a big Mandibug with his little kid. We fought one of these boss fights in Honey Hive Galaxy in Galaxy 1. It's just the same. Just ground pound him twice, and you've won, essentially. Yeah, it is a Mandibug. I just googled it. So yeah, that's that mission. That is that. Really not too tough, to be honest with you. And it's a lot of fun. Like I said, I really do like... Puzzle Plank. There we go. The words escaped me. Puzzle Plank Galaxy. And actually, the technical term for that was a Mandibug stack. But they're really not even all that much more threatening, so... Anyway. What's that gonna do? That's gonna open up the pathways to two new galaxies, and also to some star bits, which of course I will be collecting, because you can never have enough star bits, even though we have maximum, but still. Hey, looks like there's a few changes to the world map, let's check it out! That toad came back with you, right? He sure loves delivering mail! Are these two separate cutscenes here? What are you telling me? Go ahead and humor him, maybe he's got something for you. My buddy Mail Toad is back! Hey Mario, I decided to start delivering mail, and my first letter is for you! Mario, I'm in a far away... I am very far away right now, but I'm okay. I know you'll come to save me. P.S. I've attached something to this letter. I hope it will be useful. Peach. So of course Bowser is still letting us... receive mail, and she only sent us one 1-Up Mushroom. She's skimping out on us. It was 5 before, then it was 20 for a while, and now it's this. Oh, here we go. This is the Grand World Map. With the power of the Grand Star, we can travel great distances across space and time. Now we can travel to another world whenever you're ready, Captain. So this is the zoom out thing I was thinking of. As you can see, World 3 is right there, but we can't go to it yet. This shows you all the galaxies within a world. And you can hover over them to have them show you what you have and what you don't have. So, yeah, it's kind of nice. And you know what? We are going to go to this one. Hightail Falls Galaxy. This one is so much fun. Like, you do not understand. Hot Stepping Dash Pepper. Listen to the music! What is that, the athletic theme from... Is it just the Mario World? No. It's just the Mario World theme. Yeah, that's the Mario World theme, okay. At least I think it is. Anyway, we have Yoshi right here, which is freaking awesome. Any level with Yoshi is obviously gonna be a good level. What do you have to say? Climb fast! Well, as you can see, if we try and climb up here, we can't quite make it. We could infinite floater up there, but that is not an intended game mechanic. What you gotta do is eat the dash pepper right here. And then Yoshi turns orange and starts running like crazy, and he can run up all these things, and oh my god, I love it. Whee! Jeez, this is so fun. He's the same color as the Co-Star Luma. Hello. To control dash, Yoshi tilt the thing in the direction you want. Wow, okay. Thanks for telling me how to move. Anyway, speaking of the signboards, actually, I didn't mention, but in the Grand Finale Galaxy, in Galaxy 1, there was actually, I think it was either Billboard or Philboard, one of them was actually there, I never spoke to them, but they are actually there, and I'm gonna try something right here that you don't need to do right now, It is in a later mission where you actually have to do this, but you can actually go up here. And Panguru's up here! Come on, Yoshi. Let it wear off, bro. There you go. Panguru! Your skill has brought you very far. Quite a view, is it not? From here, it's clear how important every coin truly is. Okay, and also... never mind. Someone told me in the comments of the last episode that if you hit buttons on the D-pad, the Coastal Luma makes noise. No, he doesn't. You can shake. You can make him jump. Nothing else does anything. Okay. Well, you were unfortunately incorrect, good sir and or madam. So, yeah. Anyways, a bunch of star bits right here. I don't know why I'm even bothering collecting star bits, because we have 9,999 in the bank toad already. I don't know. I'm still going to obviously be collecting them just because it's fun to collect star bits, but, you know. Alright, so once we dash past here, these platforms do actually fall. We're going to have to jump. There we go. Let's make our way over here, because we got a little spinny dude to take us to another planet. Now, we have Yoshi for this one, so it shouldn't be as bad. Oh, God. Okay, there we go. If we just keep doing two at a time like that. No! Oh, my God! What? Is that, like, the second death in the project? Where's Yoshi? Oh, my God. Yoshi. Yoshi. Ugh. Okay. Well... that was unfortunate. That's gonna be like only like the second death. I know I died once in Yoshi Star Galaxy. I wasn't expected to die again yet. Also, let's try this. Oh, bad idea. Infinite. 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 There we go. That's where it comes in handy. Alright, let's try this again. By like jumping. Oh, wow. That's actually a decent strategy. Just like eat them and then land on them. Oh, whoops. Yoshi, please. Yoshi, please. Come here. Okay. Grab this guy and get this last guy. And get the one-ups. There we go. Okay, that's all I wanted. I just wanted the one-ups. I didn't mind about anything else. And there comes the star bit. Okay. So now we're in the final area of this particular mission. We're gonna get the dash pepper and run on this wall, which is freaking cool. Of course, the Coastal Luma can help you grab those star bits, but... I don't actually have a player too, I just think he's adorable. And we have another hungry Luma over here. Which of course we won't be feeding right away. So I'll note that in my memory that we have another secret star to take care of right there. Oh, comet medal. Oh, dang it, I missed the comet medal. Hold on. Let's go back down. Because you can actually just jump back down if you miss that, which is nice. Oh, I didn't... okay, I grabbed it right away. Let's see if we can get this comet medal. Even if we just run up to it, there we go, we can just fall back down and we'll be fine. Oh god, okay. This game is beautiful. I know I said that a whole bunch about the first game, this one's just as beautiful, if not more beautiful-er. That's not a word. But you know what I mean. There we go, made it around here, we got these little flower thingies that we've got to spin on again. Oh god. There we go. And we can actually just go like this to skip over to here. You're supposed to use the dash pepper to reach this. But I'm actually just going to use the infinite flutter. Because, screw this game. No, I love this game to pieces. It's easily one of my favorite games of all time. But still, I just like using the dash, using the infinite flutter. And also, we got to see Mario, Yoshi, the Power Star, and the Coastal Luma in the ending cutscene, which is freaking awesome. There we go. 14 stars, 9 comet medals, not bad. Now, I don't know when the prankster comets actually start appearing. That probably won't be for a little while, but it does happen. They appear eventually, and that is what the comet medals are for, so... yeah. Alright, and I guess we got a hungry Luma right here, wants 700. And actually, I guess it's kind of good that I'm collecting star bits, because I'm not having to dip into my savings. Yeah, let's do the hungry Luma, because that galaxy up there might take a little while, and usually hungry Luma galaxies are kind of short, so... I guess we'll take this one on right now. Yeah, we found a hungry Luma. Thank you, Lubba. You want 700, right, buddy? Yes, he does. Okay, take this. Of course, unlike the coin hungry Lumas, you actually have to point and shoot. There we go. He is going to transform! Was that me saying transform or the Luma saying transform? We'll never know. Huh. I actually don't remember what this galaxy is. Let's see. What do we got? We have... Oh, Honeybloom! Okay. Let's do Honeybloom Galaxy then. I'll take it. I'll take it. This isn't one of my favorite galaxies, but it's alright. Bumble Beginnings. Do you recognize that music? This is, of course, similar in a way to Honey Hive, because, you know, Honey Bloom. But, yeah, we're gonna be using the bee shroom. The bee shroom is making its return. And I'll be honest, I am excited for it, because I actually like the bee shroom, so... You know, also, if we fall down here, there is actually stuff down here. It's just a couple coins, but it's not death if you fall down that pit. Alright, let's get it back up here. Sweet, okay. It's so weird going from recording Mario Kart 7 to recording this series, because this series I always have something to talk about. Mario Kart 7 is a very different style of commentary at this point. It's weird. Anyway, you transformed into B Mario. Hold A to buzz around. Press and hold down A. Thanks, bro. I know how to use the B. And there's a checkpoint right there, which is very nice. They put some sneaky water around here that you could accidentally hit to lose your bee suit, but I'm sure we'll be good. And we got these guys right here, name on the screen, I don't recall it, but he's an ugly dude, so... I'm gonna call him Ugly Bird. Die. Oh crap, now he's in my way. Move, please. No, this is bad. Okay, that could have been really bad. All right, let's try this again. Of course, only B Mario can stand on these clouds and these flowers. Not these cloud flowers, that would be different. That would be also Cloud Mario who could do that, but, you know. Grab a couple star bits right there. Okay, I like the perspective in this level. It takes you at like 90 degree angles. I think it's really cool. All right, so once you grab this vine, you can't actually spin on these vines, but a bunch of star bits do come out that you can grab. Oh, look, you can try and grab. I've literally, like, never been able to grab many of these. Alright, now we're in this little bouncy area. Now, did we get the Comet Medal already? I don't know. It doesn't tell us. Is there a Comet Medal? I don't think... Oh, yeah, we did get the Comet Medal. Where the heck was the Comet Medal? I completely forgot. Anyway. And so in here, you gotta bounce off of these things to sort of navigate and... get higher up, I guess. They also refill your fly gauge a little bit, so that's helpful. And there we go, that's how you get past that section. We got a friggin' checkpoint and another mushroom should we need it, which we do not. So, yay! Alright, we got fuzzies right here. New to Galaxy 2, I believe. I don't remember seeing them in Galaxy 1. I'm sure you guys remember fuzzies. They've been in various Mario games, and... they're one of my favorite enemies. They're a pain in the backside to deal with, but they're just so weird and... neat. Anyway, can we make it up here? Is that a thing we can do? It's not a thing we can do. Okay, try that again. I think I need to get more of a swing, and then actually, oh, never mind. I was gonna try and stand on top of that. Let's get a bit more of a swing going then. Yeah. This should do it. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna make it. We are gonna make it. Okay. I think it's just a couple star bits, a few star bits up here, but still, it's nice to find little hidden areas like that. I really do like finding hidden stuff, and most of this stuff, I've found on my own time. I've played through this game so many times, just like with Galaxy 1, and most of this secret stuff I just found by myself, and I'm not able to collect any of those, am I? I just found most of the secret stuff by myself, and I'm really proud of myself for it. Alright, this thing! I don't know its name, but it's like a spiky, ball, gooey plant thing, and it's gross. And it will target you. I don't believe you can kill them. You also got these flowers right here. I imagine they have separate names, but they actually will try to eat you. So, yeah, that's nice. You just gotta not stay on them for too long so that they don't eat you. Because that's not very nice. Don't eat me, plant. You're a flower thing. You're not supposed to be deadly. All right. We are probably going to go a little bit over time on this episode. In fact, can I get up there? This is one secret I don't think I have checked out. I don't know if we can get up there. Oh god. No, if I go down, it'll eat me. Okay, we bounced off the top of it. I can hear the star as well. Yeah, this episode's probably going to run a little bit over time. I'm not too worried about that because, I mean, we did some new stuff. We started up World 2, so... Yeah, and there we go. You know, I kind of wish that you could see the power-ups in the Stargate cutscenes. I mean, you can't, but I kind of wish you could. I think it'd be kind of neat, but oh well. There we go. Bumble Beginnings, not bad. And we got the Comet Medal, okay. And what's that going to do? That's going to open... Wow, we can already go pretty much to the boss level. Hi, Mail Toad.
Mario, I have a letter for you.
Oh, I don't remember what voice I gave this guy, but someone in the comments said I should give him a chilled out voice, so I guess we'll do that.
Hey, yo, remember me? I got a new game over in the Fluffy Bluff Galaxy. Come on by, we'll do the whole instructions thing. I want to see what kind of game skills you got from the champ.
The hell was that voice? I can't do that again if I tried. So, the chimp has invited us back over for a little challenge. We are, of course, not going to be doing that right away. I am yawning. Why? There's the Co-Star Luma. We are, of course, not going to be doing that right away. We're actually going to be ending this episode off here. So, as always, if you guys enjoyed, make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of the episode in the comment section below. And thank you all for watching. I didn't say thank you all for watching this time. Thank you all for watching. And I think those star bits straight up did disappear out of the sky, didn't they? There's some seagulls, but we can't collect those. I don't think those star bits that were in, like, the very first thing are available anymore. Because wasn't it before we went to World 1? I think it might have been before we went to World 1. I don't think it's here anymore. Anyway, that is going to do it. So once again, thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next one. And we'll see you guys... We'll see you guys then.